now number one. Top seven going on to the 49,000 win. Well, good IMC 103.5 Rocky with the stars, seven all stars, A-Main here this evening. Knoxville, Tennessee's Billy Oval in the 201, the 22 offensive Tennessee's Mike Weeks set to bring up the green in the start box here at turn four. Green's out and here we go. Billy Oval Jr. jumps to the race lead. Mike Weeks gonna go to second. Mark Rosner will be third. Vic Hill fourth. Josh Collins fifth. Mark Vineyard sixth. The 97 of Bobby Gibbon into seventh and final transfer spot as we got one lap of 10 interval. Mark Vineyard looking to get the fifth spot away from Josh Collins. Working the bottom side of the racing surface off turn two. Put Mark Vineyard into position number five. Meanwhile, up front, Billy Ogle Jr. looking high, wide, and handsome off turn number four. Down the front straightaway with about six car lengths on the middle man, Mike Weeks, down into turn number one. While Mark Rosner, about four car lengths off, Weeks is back bumper down the back straightaway as they are hauling the mail literally here at Smoky Mountain Speedway this evening in PPM Racing Products. Last chance showdown number one. Ogle the leader, Mike Weeks second, Mark Rosner third, Vic Hill rides in fourth, Mark Vineyard fifth, Josh Collins sixth, Bobby Gibbons seventh. Then it's Robbie Moses, Brett Holmes, and a Sammy Russell. George Mashburn not making the call for this one. As we start to roll it on the halfway signal, the cross stick signal going out, five in the books, five to go. MPPM Racing Products, last chance showdown number one. And it's all Billy the Kid, Billy Oval Jr. And the Mount Motorsports Rocket number 201 showing the way. With the double deuce, the black and white 22 of Mike Weeks, last year's Southern All-Stars Rookie of the Year, riding in the bridesmaid position. Third is the 17 of Rocco, Tennessee's Mark Rosner. Mosheim, Tennessee's Vic Hill. He slips up in turn number two. He may have problems on the number one. Vic Hill slowing on the back straightaway and he'll draw the caution flag. He may have a flat tire on the number one. Looks like a possible flat right rear. And race fans, if you are... Billy Ogle, the race leader, will bring on the in between the start cones. They're off turn four. Green flag is out, and we're back underway with last number one. And Billy Ogle showing the way here this evening so far in the first last chance showdown of the night. Ogle, the leader. Weeks second, Rosner third, Vineyard fourth, Collins fifth, Giffen sixth, Moses holding down the seventh and final transfer position. White flag in the air, one lap remaining here in PPM Racing Products. Last chance showdown number one. Again, the top seven finishers will go on, and everyone else, unless they've got a provisional, will transfer to the trailer and be done for the night. Off of turn four, PPM Racing Products last chance showdown number one. We'll go to Knoxville, Tennessee's Billy Ogle Jr. second. Be the 22 of Mike Weeks, third. The 17 of Mark Rosner, fourth. The four of Mark Vineyard, fifth. The 63 of Josh Collins, sixth. To the 97. Making the show, the 15-year-old Brett. And the one to go signal being shown will be coming to green next time by 10 laps, and we'll take seven more out of this one on to the fourth lap. A-Main coming out of PPM Racing Products last chance showdown at number two. Tommy Kerr and Brett Miller bring them to green. Green flags out, and here we go. They'll drag race them into turn number one, side by side for the top spot, and Brett Miller jumps out of there with the race lead. Tommy Kerr second. And he'll get some pressure from the 11B of Stacy Bowles as they work off turn four down the front straightaway. David Crabtree is fourth, Scott James fifth, Brad Hall is sixth, Randy Weaver in the seventh and final transfer spot with one lap of 10 in the books here in PPM Racing Products Last Chance Showdown number two. Up front, Brett Miller looking good in that black and yellow number 47 machine. Tommy Kerr holding down the runner-up slot with Clinton, Tennessee, Stacy Bowles third. Then it's a bit of a gap back to the fourth place machine, the C5 of David Crabtree, who's got a back bumper full of Scott James in the 1G. Then it's Brad Hall in the 23 and Randy Weaver in the 116. Those are your seven transfer cars. Dusty Carver grabs the first spot on the outside. Look at him. That's eighth away from Hunter Peacock. Then it's Bo Shirley and Chuck Laney. Meanwhile, Brad Miller continues to show the way while Clinton, Tennessee, Stacy Bowles rolls in on Rockwood, Tennessee's Tommy Kerr off of turn four, looking to get racy for the bridesmaid spot. Five down, five to go in PPM Racing Products B main number two. And Kerr got a good run off turn two right there. He's starting to close in on race leader Brett Miller here as they work off four down the front straightaway with six in the books. Four to go with PPM Racing Products B main, last chance showdown B main number two. As Miller's car pushing tight there off turn two and Kerr all over his back bumper into turn three. You could throw grandma's blanket over the top three coming off turn four down the front straightaway here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. And PPM Racing Products last chance showdown number two. Bowles thought about taking a look to the inside of Kerr. He's going to try it again through turns three and four. He's in the basement off of turn four. He and Kerr make contact. All this going on behind race leader Brett Miller in the 47. Miller now with a little bit of breathing room with Kerr and Bowles racing hard. Dusty Carver out of Englewood, Tennessee pulls the nine machine to the infield pit area as the white flag waves. One lap to go here in PPM Racing Products last chance showdown number two. And Miller getting crossed up again off of turn number two. Let's Kerr close in. Off of turn four for the final time. Brad Miller will grab the win. Tommy Kerr will go second. Stacy Bowles will come home in third. Scott James will finish fourth. David Crabtree fifth. Brad Hall sixth. And Randy Weaver comes home in seventh. Jeff McLemore, Greg Humphrey in row one. David Price and Scott Brown in row two. Walter Walsh in row number three. At the white barrel coming off turn four. Green's out, looking good this time. And we are racing in the street stock heat race event here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. And the J3 of Jeff McLemore going to jump to the race lead with the nine of Greg Humphrey in second. The one of David Price will be third. The 368X of Scott Brown will be fourth with the 3RD of Walter Walsh in a fifth. And Jeff McLemore looking good down the front straightaway with one lap of six in the books. And looks like Walter Walsh going to pull the 3RD into the infield. His heat race done. Meanwhile, the J3 of Jeff McLemore pulling away from second place running Greg Humphrey in the number nine. With third being the one of David Price and fourth the 368X of Scott Brown. As we should be halfway right here, I do believe. There'll be three in the books this time by three down, three to go. And tonight's street stock qualifying heat race. These drivers running a heat since they did peel draw four starting positions and did not qualify here this evening. Four in the books, two to go, and it is all Jeff McLemore out in front. He and the J3 Chevrolet Monte Carlo. The nine of Greg Humphrey is second, with the one of David Price starting to put some pressure on him from his third spot here off turn number four. As the white flag goes down, one lap to go here in street stock heat race action this evening at Smoky Mountain Speedway.
the checkered flag in hand. He can coast it in from here. Jeff McLemore, winner of the Street Stock Heat this evening. Second, we'll go to the nine of Greg Humphrey. Third to the one of David Price, and fourth to the 368X of Scott Brown. So Scott Brown will be front straight away. Wave your hands and arms and caps in the air. Southern All-Star Racing Series. WIMZ 103.5 rocking with the stars here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. Here they are. Green flag in hand, flags up. We're coming to green next time by. And crew members in the infield, make sure you keep yourself behind that wall, please. Superman, Jonathan Davenport in the Tar Heel Tiger, Ray Cook bringing him to green. They'll fire in between the two orange cones off turn number four here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime! Everyone looks like they've made it through turn one and two safely. Cook and Davenport side by side up for the top spot. Give it to Ray Cook down the front straightaway as they work to complete lap number one here in the WIMZ 103.5 rocking with the stars, with the Southern All-Stars at Smoky Mountain Speedway. Ray Cook the leader, Jonathan Davenport in second, Dale McDowell rides in third, Mark Douglas fourth, as Bo Shirley slowing over on the back straightaway. The Gadsden, Alabama native will duck the 111 machine into the infield. Looks like his night already finished. Cook the leader, Davenport second, Dale McDowell third, Mark Douglas is the fourth, Riley Hickman sets in the fifth spot, Oxford, Alabama's Jason Hyatt is sixth, David Payne seventh, Steve Case Bolt eighth, Billy Ogle Jr. ninth, Brett Miller is up to tenth. And good racing back there for positions 11 through 16. As Ray Cook and Jonathan Davenport setting a torrid pace at the point. Cook working off turn number four down the front straightaway as lap number five goes up on the board. Five down, 35 to go. As Hunter Peacock's number 12 will go a lap down, and he's going to look slow, and looks like he'll duck into the infield. His night already finished. Cook still your leader, Davenport in second, then it's several car lengths, almost a half straightaway. Back to the third place battle between the 17M of Dale McDowell and the 52D of Mark Douglas. Douglas trying to poke a nose to the inside of McDowell, but nothing doing there. As the lead duo of Ray Cook and Jonathan Davenport close in on the rear of the field, action business is about to pick up at the point. As the lead duo will start to work slower traffic here momentarily. Douglas trying to negotiate McDowell off two, not able to make the move as McNightdaddy closes the door on him. And Riley Hickman starting to close in on Mark Douglas from his fifth position. Davenport taking a look to the inside of Cook, down the back straightaway, working on lap number nine. He'll use the lap car for a pick, put Davenport to the point now. Off of turn number four with nine laps in the books. Ray Cook now, he'll try to work back beneath Davenport, off two down the back straightaway. As they come up on the slower car, I believe that's Josh Collins now off of turn number four. Cook may have to check up. He will, Davenport to the outside of Collins. Good battle up front with 10 in the books, we're a quarter of the way home. Superman on the point with the Tar Heel Tiger in second, McDaddy riding third, Mark Douglas fourth, and Riley Hickman continues to hold down fifth. Jason Hyatt sixth, Billy Ogle Jr. seventh. David Payne, 8th, Steve Case Bolt Jr., 9th, Steve Case Bolt 9th, and Brett Miller 10th. As Brad Hall's 23s roll slowly down the front straightaway, he'll duck into the infield, will stay green. Davenport took the lead on lap 9, and he's got the Tar Heel Tiger nipping at his heels, though, as they set him down into turn number 1 with 12 in the books. Davenport and Cook start to close in on the 17 machine of Mark Rossner. That'll be the next car they attempt to put a lap down. Oh, close quarter right there for Davenport. He had to check up to keep from getting into the rear of Rossner. Cook's got to take a look to the outside of Davenport. All four down the front straightaway. They are inches apart in lap traffic. Too close to call that time by at the line. Davenport working beneath Rossner. May have made some contact. Keeps the race lead. Gives himself just a bit of breathing room on Ray Cook now down in the turn number three. Dale McDowell continues to hold down position number three as Riley Hickman in the R1 car rides in fourth. Now Mark Douglas fifth, Jason Hines sixth, Billy Ozell seventh, David Payne eighth, Steve Case Bolt ninth, Brett Miller still tenth. As we stay green, we're starting to close in on the halfway point of this one. Davenport to the inside of Victor Thrill Hill, and Superman will put him a lap down now off of turn number two. The lap car Vic Hill now between Jonathan Davenport and Ray Cook as they race off into turn number three. We'll have 17 laps in the books this time by 17 down, 23 remain, closing in on the midpoint. Here are the WIMZ 103.5 rocking with the stars. A-Main for the Southern All-Stars here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. Action is settled down at the front for the time being. Davenport now trying to pick his line to work around the 97 of Bobby Giffen. Ray Cook trying to find a way around the one of Vic Hill. He'll step to the high side, puts it on the top shelf up in turn three and four. But still not able to work around Vic Hill as Davenport now tries to put the 97 of Bobby Giffen a lap down off turn two down the back straightaway. Davenport into Steve Cook owned AES Racing sponsored Barry Wright race car. As David Crabtree, C5, slowing up at the top side of turn one and two. He may have a flat tire. We're going to have a caution. Caution is out. Dale McDowell to the inside of that first double file roll as they get ready to stack them up, tighten them up. Race leader Jonathan Davenport out in front all by himself. The remainder of the field got him stacked up two by two double file, just like Noah took the animals on the ark. Jonathan Davenport in charge of the start. He will bring the field to fire in between the two orange cones at the exit of turn four, halfway home. 20 down, 20 remain. Eyes on him off turn four. Green's out, and here we go. McDowell looking to the inside of Ray Cook to grab the runner-up slot here on the restart off turn two down the back straightaway. MacDaddy and the Tar Heel Tiger side by side into turn number three. Cook up on the top shelf, McDowell in the middle, and Cook will hang on to the runner-up slot. Keep McDowell in third, Mark Douglas fourth, Billy Ogle Jr. fifth, Jason Hyatt sixth, Riley Hickman there slipped back to seventh, trying to get the sixth spot back away from Oxford, Alabama's Jason Hyatt down into turn three, and he'll have that done. And Mike Weeks is going to spin here off of turn number four, and that will draw the caution flag. Didn't see what happened. He was already turned sideways. Looks like 22 laps official. 22 laps official. Yeah, 22 laps official, 18 remain. Jonathan Davenport with the field in tow. Once we get inside, 10 laps to go. There'll be single file restarts if there are any caution flags. Davenport set to pull the trigger and smash a loud pedal. Green's back at it. Here we go. Davenport will lead him off turn number two. Ray Cook is second. Dale McDowell third. Billy Ogle Jr. now up to fourth. He started in the ninth position after winning the first last chance showdown. And Ogle trying to work beneath Dale McDowell. Billy the Kid got a fast hot rod here in the late stages of this one. Trying to grab third away from MacDaddy as they work through turns three and four. Down the front straightaway. Ogle very good right there on the bottom of the racing surface in the basement. Meanwhile, Davenport and Cook putting some distance between that battle for third between the 201 of Ogle and the 17 Emma McDowell. McDowell have it by half car length at the line that time by. Jason Hyatt holds, or excuse me, yeah, Jason Hyatt now into that fifth position. Is the Oxford, Alabama native in the number one. And caution is Scott James has made contact with the concrete up outside of turn number two. 25 laps down, 25 in, 15 to go. Jonathan Davenport, the race leader, green. The racing surface clear. Chief starter Darrell Watson looking to field over. And Jonathan Davenport will fire him in the, between the start cones here off of turn number four. Eyes on him. Green's back at it. Here we go. Davenport leads him down the back straightaway. Roy Cook will out hustle Dale McDowell for that second spot. As Jason Hyatt around Billy Ogle Jr. for the fourth spot, and Mark Douglas trying to work the outside of Ogle for fifth, but Ogle back to the inside of Jason Hyatt. He'll retake the fourth spot down to turn number one. And Steve Casebolt on the move into C9. He has grabbed the sixth spot away now for Mark Douglas. Up front, it is still Jonathan Davenport showing away. Ray Cook trying to ramp up some speed on that high side and run Davenport down, but to no avail at this point. McDowell still third. Billy Ogle Jr. rides in fourth. Jason Hyatt fifth. Steve Casebolt is sixth. Mark Douglas seventh. Riley Hickman eighth. Mike Weeks in the 22 up to ninth with David Payne holding down the final spot in the top 10. Davenport and Cook are going to look to settle this one amongst themselves as they've got almost two-thirds of a straightaway cushion back to the third-place running machine of Dale McDowell. As we've got 10 laps to go, 10 to go in the WIMZ 103.5 rocking with the stars for the Southern All-Stars here this evening at Smoky Mountain Speedway. Davenport starting to stretch his lead by just a bit over Cook, but Cook pretty good through turns one and two. But Davenport appears to be better down the back straightaway and through turns three and four at this point than Cook. McDowell holding down third, Ogle fourth, with Hyatt in fifth, Steve Casebolt and Mark Douglas going at it for sixth and seventh. Casebolt in his first ever Smoky Mountain Speedway appearance holding down the sixth spot. And business may pick up at the point before this one is done, because if we stay green, the front two are going to catch lap traffic, race fans, before this one is done, possibly. A full straightaway now back between second and third, between second place Ray Cook and third place Dale McDowell, as Cook starting to maybe start to reel in race leader Jonathan Davenport as they work off two down the back straightaway. Cook closing in on Davenport inch by inch now down into turn number one. They have a half track back to third place Dale McDowell. As we've got less than five to go here now in this one, there'll be four to go this time when Davenport and Cook cross the stripe off turn four down the front straightaway, and they are going to catch lap traffic if we stay green, race fans. Davenport looking under Brett Holmes. He'll put him another lap down as McDowell tries. Casebolt on the move. Casebolt is up to fourth. He got around Billy Ogle a couple laps ago and trying to work around third place. Dale McDowell now off of turn four down the front straightaway. And put Steve Casebolt into position number three with three to go. Davenport now trying to be very careful with which line he chooses, because he doesn't know where Ray Cook's at. With two laps to go here in this one, race fans. As David Payne slowing, will it bring a caution flag out? And we've got caution as David Payne's number eight is slowed at the bottom of the entrance of turn number three. Oh my. With the classic green, white, checkered finish. And we're getting set to come back to green. Caution lights are out. Green, a white checkered to settle the issue. Single file, nose to tail. In between the start cones here off turn number four, Davenport bringing the field back to green. It's out. Green, white checkered to settle the score. McDowell and Cook motor down the back straightaway. Case Bolt third, McDowell fourth, Ogle fifth. Douglas looking to the inside of Jason Hyatt for six as the white flag waves. One lap to go here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. Davenport working down the back straightaway for the final time into turn number three. It'll be the points leader. Superman Jonathan Davenport grabs the win. Ray Cook will be second. Steve Casebo will come home in third. Fourth will be Dale McDowell, with fifth going to Billy Ogle Jr.
And he's out of the car race. Fans, give him a big round of applause. The current Southern All-Star points leader out of Blairsville, Georgia, Jonathan Davenport. Young man, congratulations. First off, talk about the battle with Ray Cook right there. You're riding second. You guys caught lap traffic, and the lap traffic played right into your hands. You was able to use that lap car for a pit, getting off into turn three, and motor by Ray.
Yeah, I tell you what, you know, sometimes it's worse being the leader when you get the lap traffic like that. You don't never know where they're going to go. This place is, you know, kind of tied anyway. But Ray had a real good car. I don't know if I could have got around him there if we hadn't had that lap traffic there. But everything worked out great. Got to thank AES Racing, Encompass Solutions, Mega Plumbing, Mega Electric, Olean Shocks, Hoosier Tires. And, you know, couldn't be more happy with my crew right now. You know, it's sometimes just amazing what you can accomplish when people believe in you. So definitely thank Steve Cook for giving me this opportunity.
First repeat winner with the Southern All-Star Racing Series in 2012, victorious last Saturday night as well, down at East Alabama Motor Speedway. Ray was closing in on you right there at the end a little bit. I don't know, did you want to see that caution with two to go, or would you rather it stayed green?
You know, it was probably a good thing we saw that caution there. You know, those lap cars was right there and was running through a little bit of crumbs. But, you know, first time here racing, I've come tested here once or twice, but I just didn't know how much tighten the car up. I was getting real, real free, and especially when I was getting lap traffic, I'd lose a little bit of side force. But everything worked out good, and keep this rolling.
Give him a big round of applause once again, Rays fans. Jonathan Davenport went in rocking with the stars here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. And lap traffic didn't go your way, though. Jonathan able to kind of use that lap car for a pick over there in turn three and got around him. Got to ask you, no, you probably would have liked to see that sucker stay green right there because you guys were starting to close in on slower traffic there at the end.
Yeah, I mean, just congratulations to Jonathan. I think we had about equal cars, and, you know, it just took lap cars to separate us. And I had him in the crosshairs there with the last lap, you know, and the caution come out. But, I mean, you know, they done the right thing. This car sitting on the racetrack, but just like to thank all my sponsors, you know, Masters Build and Joe Denby with A-Plus Moving and Storage. If it wasn't for those guys, we probably wouldn't be here. And, you know, Jay Dickens, the motor run good tonight, and Integra Shocks. Just everything on our car performed really well.
And you get to come back here in 3 weeks and take the driving suit off, put the promoter's cap on with the Schaefer Oil Spring Nationals. You know, you got to be looking forward to coming back.
Well, I'm telling you, we are. And hats off to all the track crew here. I'm telling you, I'd give anything to get my racetrack this smooth. I mean, this thing, it's like a paved highway with the most grip you can get, you know, and it's just really fast. And they've done a good job, and we're looking forward to it with the cars we're going to bring back in here. I think it'll be exciting.
Big round of applause for second place finisher Ray Cook this evening, race fans.
Lap 10 to 15, somewhere between laps 10 and 15. Street stocks, you'll need to go to staging, please. The 10 of Chris Wilson, the 66 of Adam Beeler to bring the field to the green flag at the white start cone off turn four. Green's out, and here we go. And they're going to drag race down the front straightaway and into turn number one. And Chris Wilson with about a half car length as we got caution already to 0-1. Matt Murphy into the concrete at the top side of the center of turn one and two. And also car spun in the center of the back straightaway there. He'll try it again. Chris Wilson and Adam Beeler bringing the field down here off of turn four. Green is out. Here we go. And Adam Beeler going to jump to the top spot. Chris Wilson in second. Corey Hitchcock looks to be third. David Crabtree fourth. Ryan King fifth. And the 22 machine of Rusty Webb into the back straightaway wall. You can see that black streak he has left on those freshly painted walls down the back straightaway. And I'm sure his machine going to have to go on the hook here.
As
the go
well.
Signal shown once again. We'll try to get her going clean and green here for you next time by. Hopefully third time will be the charm. We'll get this one going nice and green here for you. And that dog won't hunt right there. Adam Beeler getting a little anxious, trying to get a good start there. Lined up beside post hitter Chris Wilson. Barrel there at the exit of turn number four. Then they can smash the loud pedal and get it on. Chief starter Darrell Watson looking to field over many, many years in the flag stand. Longtime flagman here and also at the old Atomic Speedway. Wilson and Beeler with the field in tow. They'll try it again. Green waves looking good. Here we go. Chris Wilson got to jump out to the top spot. David Crabtree looks to be in the second spot. Adam Beeler third. Corey Hitchcock fourth. Ryan King fifth. Yes, we're going to get one lap officially scored. Everyone through clean and safely on lap number one. As Corey Hitchcock works to the inside of Adam Beeler. And we got a spin over in turn number two. The 98 of Jason McCall loops his machine. That will draw the caution flag. And problems on right. Unbutton the hood there and take a peek beneath the hood of the number 30 machine. We do have one lap officially in the book. One official, Chris Wilson, the leader. David Crabtree second, Adam Beeler third, Corey Hitchcock fourth, James Kelso eighth. And Ryan King's crew still at work beneath the hood of his number 30 machine. As race officials try to get the field to tighten them up, single file nose to tail. As they get ready to pull the trigger on them here off turn four. Green's back at it. Here we go. And Corey Hitchcock to the inside of Adam Beeler. Beeler gets sideways and Patrick Dugan helped finish him off. And that draws the caution flag. Chris Wilson with the field in tow. We get one lap officially in the book. Wilson the leader, Crabtree second, Patrick Dugan third, Hunter Best fourth, and Roger Best fifth. Green is out, and we are back underway. Wilson leading Crabtree down the back straightaway with the 28 machine of Patrick Dugan trying to hold off the youngster Hunter Best for that battle for third. And Dugan will have that done for the time being as we've got two laps now scored. And the front two of Chris Wilson in the 10, the C5 of David Crabtree, putting some distance between himself now in the third place running machine, the 28 of Patrick Dugan. Hunter Best fourth, Roger Bass fifth, Corey Hitchcock sixth, James Kelso seventh, James Cole rides in eighth with the 98 of Jason McCall ninth. And Chris Wilson starting to put some track between himself and second place running David Crabtree. And then it's almost a half straightaway back to the battle for third between the 28 of Patrick Dugan and the 007 of Hunter Bess. As we close it on the one third point of this one, Chris Wilson bringing them off turn number four. There'll be eight in the books this time, a third of the way home here in tonight's 25-lap crate lay model feature. Wilson continues to show the way with David Crabtree riding in second, Patrick Dugan third, Hunter Best fourth, Roger Best fifth, Corey Hitchcock sixth, James Kelso seventh, Jason McCall eighth, and James Cole ninth. And the 98 of Jason McCall's machine slowing going down the back straightaway. And he's going to make the left-hand turn into the infield. His night is finished. As the field getting around the five machine of James Cole, putting him a lap down, does the first and second place cars of Chris Wilson and David Crabtree. As we start to close it on the midpoint, we'll have 12 laps scored this time, 12 down, a lucky 13 laps to go here in tonight's Crate Lay Model main event. And it's the Chris Wilson, David Crabtree show up front right now. Wilson's led it the entire way, Crabtree in second. And then a lot of racetrack back to the third place car there in turn number three, the 28 of Patrick Dugan with the 007 of Hunter Best in fourth. The 5 of Roger Best, 5th, the 23 of Corey Hitchcock, 6th, the 49 of James Kelso is 7th. He's the final car on the lead lap at this point. The race leader, Chris Wilson, starting to burn out on him as they work off turn 2 down the back straightaway. Ten laps remaining in tonight's crate feature in the 10 of Chris Wilson. Gonna put a lap on the 49 of James Kelso down into turn number three. The 8 laps remaining this time, and it is all Chris Wilson out in front. As the C5 of David Crabtree now, he attempts to get by the slower car, James Kelso down the back straightaway. It into turn three, and it's a full straightaway back to the third place running machine, the 28 of Patrick Dugan. And Dugan with about 8 car lengths on a fourth place running, the 007 of Hunter Best. As Corey Hitchcock working beneath the 5 of veteran Roger Best off 4 down the front straightaway, but Best going to hang on to the 5th spot in that number 5 at this point. As there are 6 laps to go here now in tonight's Crate Lay Model feature. A little bit of a shaky start getting things going, but they've gotten strung out and racing very nicely now throughout the waning stages of this one. As the 5 machine of James Cole, the next car under Chris Wilson's assault, goes the lap down off 2 down the back straightaway. Only 6 cars remain on the lead lap. the sixth place car, the 23 of Corey Hitchcock, the final car on the lead lap. Three laps remain for Chris Wilson to pick up the win here at Smoky Mountain Speedway this evening. Street stocks, you should be staged and ready to go. Street stocks, you should be staged and ready to go. Two laps to go here in this one. Off of turn number four, race leader Chris Wilson. We'll see Darrell Watson's white flag. One lap to go in this evening's Crate Lane Model Main Event. And through turns three and four for the final time. Off of turn four, your Crate Lane Model Feature Race win will go to Chris Wilson in the number 10. David Crabtree will come home second into C5. A very distant third will be the 28 of Patrick Dugan, fourth to the 007 of Hunter Best. And a fifth will go to that number five right there of Roger Best. Again, big round of applause for tonight's Cradley Model Feature Event winner, Chris Wilson, leading flag to flag here in tonight's Cradley Model Main Event. Congratulations there, young man. Fifteen laps will be the distance. And again, race fans, some of you starting to make your way to the exits. Thank you for being at Smoky Mountain Speedway this evening, supporting the Southern All-Stars and the Crate Lane Model and Street Stocks here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. Please drive safely. As Chief Starter Darrell Watson shows the field, the one to go signal will be coming to green next time by. 15 laps the scheduled distance. And Jeff McLemore in a J3, very impressive in the street stock heat race earlier this evening. And eyes out of here off turn four. Green flag is down, the final feature of the night here underway. Jeff McLemore showing the way in the number three. Greg Humphrey Rhines in second. David Price third. Scott Brown in fourth. Walter Walsh fifth. And the 368X machine of Scott Brown minus the right rear wheel and tire. And green is is out, and we're back underway here in tonight's street stock feature. And Jeff McLemore in the J3, showing away. Greg Humphrey second, David Price is third, Walter Walsh fourth. Yeah, Walter Walsh looks like he'll call it a night. Parks the 3RD in the infield. And the one of David Price trying to work around the nine of Greg Humphrey, but not able to do so there at the exit of turn number two. The J3 of Jeff McLemore driving away from him here. As we'll be a third of the way finished. Five down, 10 to go in tonight's street stock main event. And it is all Jeff McLemore out in front. David Price battling with Greg Humphrey for that second spot, but not able to find a way around him at this point. Still Jeff McLemore with a very comfortable lead, about three quarters of a straightaway back to second place running Greg Humphrey. As we're halfway home in this one, eight down, seven to go in tonight's street stock main event. And don't forget, race fans, the next action is Smoky Mountain Speedway comes up here Saturday night, April the 13th. Ray Cook Schaefer Oil Spring National, $6,000 to win for Super Late Models that Saturday evening, April 13th. Along with the American Modified Series, it'll be the AMS 2013 Series Opener. $3,000 to win for the Open Wheelers that evening, along with street stocks and mini stocks. Jeff McLemore with it on cruise control, literally. Working off turn number four. There'll be four laps to go this time. Four remaining here in tonight's street stock main event. Correction, looks like five. Looks like white flag in hand this time off of turn number four to race leader Jeff McLemore. One lap to settle the issue here in this one. And Chief Strider Darrell Watson with the checkered flag in hand. And off of turn number four, Jeff McLemore will be the winner of tonight's street stock main event. And he's got problems. He put some fluid down there as he took a checkered flag. Greg Humphrey got to finish second with David Price third. And that one right there may have had a 15-lap fuse on it because she put some liquid down there. You can see it just as he exited turn number four. And going to check him out, make sure the driver not injured during any hot fluid or anything getting back on him. A lot of steam and smoke coming from that race. This evening at Smoky Mountain Speedway, thank you so much for braving the cool weather this evening. Please drive home safely. buckle up, leave the speed to the pros on the racetrack, and we'll see you down the road at the races. God bless.